Hello student, in this video or a module we will discuss about the chapter adverb, its degree of comparison, and we will come to know about the types of adverb or the various uses of adverb where we use according to the different situations. So first let us start with the definition of the adverb. What does it mean? An adverb is a word that adds something more to the meaning of a verb. An adverb can modify a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. So with this definition we come to conclusion that the adverbs are the word which we use to describe more about the action, that is the verb. So all those word which says more about our action or the verb is called an adverb. For example, he speaks clearly. Here you can see he is the subject, speaks is your verb, that is action, and the action is being done how? Clearly. So clearly describes more about the action of speaking. Number two, you can see they were extremely tired. So here also extremely word describe more about the tiredness of the people. Then next statement you see, Sneha walked briskly up the garden path. So the walking, the action walked, is being described by the word with the help of the word briskly. So this all three word, that is clearly, extremely, and briskly, is what? An adverb. Now let us start with the kinds of adverb. One by one I will explain you all the kinds of adverb which will help you to understand that how they are being used according to the demand of the statement. For example, number one, we will understand the adverb of time. They tell us about the time of action. So when our action happened, so all those words which describes about the taking place of action, when that action or that kind of a verb has taken place, so all that we can understand with the adverb of time. For example, the conference began early. Early depicts that this happened earlier. She will come tomorrow. Again, the timing for to come her is what? Next, that is tomorrow. The boys are sleeping now. So the action is what? The sleeping, that is what? Now the boys are sleeping. So they are what? Adverb of time. Next is your adverb of place, that indicate where an action takes place or took place. So regarding the action, the place of action, that is considered under the adverb of place. For example, the teacher looked for Meena everywhere. They were going out. Due to flood, there was water everywhere. My friend lives here. So in all the statement, you can understand here, everywhere, out, and here. All these are the location for the action to be happened or to take place. So these are what? Adverb of place. Next is your adverb of frequency. So they indicate how often an action takes or took place. So how many times that action happened or going to happen or took place. Okay, so we will have some example here. She visits her friend occasionally, that means sometime. He rarely visits the museum. Rita often helps her mother in the garden. So this is how we have defined the action, that how often, how many times, or is it frequently done, or sometime, or rarely, that means very less. So all these we consider under the adverb of frequency, how the action has taken place, how many times, how frequently the action took place. Then your next is your adverb of degree, that indicates the intensity of an action and answer the question how much. So now the action, how it was done, what is the intensity, the depth of the action, that we consider under the adverb of degree. Now let us understand with the example. He almost fell asleep when the movie ended. The story was very scary. The cuckoo sings very sweetly. So the action, that is sweetly, scary, and fall asleep, is again described with the kind of a degree, the intensity of the adverb. Alright, now number five is your adverb of manner. They tell us about the action take or took place, that is the action, kind of action, what type of action happened. For example, the prince fought bravely in the battle. So how the action, how the prince fought bravely. So this bravely is what? The adverb of manner. Nisha is carefully driving the car. The player practiced sincerely. So here carefully and sincerely again describe the manner of the action, how the person have done that action. Your next is your relative adverb that relate the other part of the statement. So these adverbs, they refer to the things or the person that the pronoun referred to. For example, do you remember when we last visited the planetarium? I cannot find the house where my aunt lived earlier. They come here whenever they are free. So all these places, when, where and whenever, they are relating the pronouns. That means first part of the statement and the other one. So here they relate to each other. So that is what here this work as an relative adverb. For example, you just see, they come here whenever they are free. So the pronoun they are related to this part of the subject with the word whenever. Here also my aunt, okay, that my aunt is related to I using the where. So this is how the relative adverb works. Then interrogative adverb, they are used to ask questions about time, place, manner, number, quantity and reason. There are few example given here. Where does she live? That is your place is asked. When will you call back? That is the time. How often do you go shopping? That is your frequency. All these are what? Interrogative adverb. Coming to the exclamatory adverb, this express the degree or extent in the exclamation form. So it can be these kinds of adverb. Generally, you must have read in class 7 and all. So it is also, it was there. So I wish to explain you so that you can have this thorough idea about this adverb also. So it's given here, how beautiful is she danced, what a lovely view. So these are what? Exclamatory form of adverb. Then your next is your adverb of affirmation or negation, that is your positive or a negative. So it can be expressed in a both the form. That will, you can see the example, she will definitely come, that is understood positive form, and she is not willing to go, that is the negative type of a adverb. So these are the types of adverb that we have understood. Now one or two things are more to understand. That is the sentence adverb. They modify a complete sentence and not just part of it. These are formed by adding ly to the adjective. For example, clearly they perform well and won the trophy. Second, you can see the example, obviously the criminals had to be punished by law. So these are these type of statement which clearly modify the complete statement, not just a part of it. So obviously this completely say about the all the parts of the word which have been used in this statement. So these words are what? The sentence adverbs. Then adverb of reason, when we apply the reason for that statement. These adverbs logically connect the conclusion with the argument made in the previous sentence. So it gives the reason, and that is why we say what? Adverb of reason. For example, I am not keeping well. So this is the first part of the statement. Hence, I am unable to accompany you. So this is how we are using here word hence. Hence is what? Adverb of reason. It is the second, it gives the reason why the person is not well or not keeping well, and so the person is not going to come. So this is what the adverb of reason here we can understand with the word. Now coming to the position of adverb where we apply here. Adverb of manner, so generally place and time, so these three, adverb of manner, place and time are placed between the subject and the verb. So you can understand, she always recited the poem well. So here you can understand, subject is what? She. Recited is your verb. In between is what? Always. So this kind of adverb, they are placed between the subject and the verb. Adverb can be placed at the beginning. Okay, so sometime you will see the adverb are in the beginning of the statement. For example, soon the girl returned to the hostel. Sometime adverb is also placed in the middle. For example, she occasionally visit her guardian's house. So occasionally is what? Your adverb. Then at the end of the statement also you will find the adverb. So that is what? She will visit their house again. Alright, some more statement which I would like to explain you, that how the position has been used is here. For example, adverb of time may be placed right at the beginning of a sentence for emphasis. Example, you can say today. So in this kind of a statement, we place the adverb in the beginning. Today we will visit the museum. Alright. Or recently she won the best speaker award. So this is what the adverb of time we have placed in the beginning of the statement. Now if the verbs are different from of be, different form of be, that is am, is, are, was, where, will be, the adverbs are placed after the verb. For example, this is your being form of the verb is Ganesh is never rude. So after this being form of the verb, we have used what? adverb. For here also there is example, the trainees are always early. So again here this is what being form of the verb, and we have placed the adverb always after the being form of the verb. Now next is what, if there is a stress on the verb of be for or the auxiliary, then the adverb usually comes before it. For example, she certainly is a better dancer. So when we focus on or when we give the emphasis, then this is how we can place the adverb. Then next one, you see, he definitely was an efficient administrator. We are again giving importance the emphasis over there. So we have used the word here, he definitely. So this is how we can understand how we are focusing on the being form of the verb, and we are placing such word, such kind of adverb over here. Next is what, if there is an object, the adverb is generally placed after the object. But if the object is very long, we usually put the adverb before the verb. For example, she signed the lease deed immediately. So here lease deed is what, the object. So just after the object we apply what, adverb. So these we have discussed about the position of the adverb. This is how you can do. Now let us discuss about the degree of comparison. The adverb can be used in the three form, that is the positive, comparative and the superlative. So some examples I have just made for you to understand. So positively we can use as adverb fast, it will change into faster when we compare, and in the superlative form it will change into what, fastest. In the same way, bravely, more, we have added here more bravely and the most bravely. Badly, worse and the worst. Late, comparative will be later, superlative will be latest. Positive will be much, comparative will be more, and superlative will be most. Now formation of adverb, generally how we make the changes to make a word into adverb form, that is what we are applying what, ly. Okay, so this is warm will change into warmly, lazy into lazily, slow into slowly, eager into eagerly. Somewhere ily we have used, for example in the lazily word, or heavy into heavily, happy into happily. So that also again depend upon the word. So go through all the words and the statement and the example in your book and solve out all the exercises. Thank you.